Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thank Cairo University College of Agriculture for this great gather, scientific gather, which I hope it will lead to shorten the gap between the consumption in Egypt and the productivity in the agriculture sector, which has major challenges. Egypt increases every year about 2.5 million people. At the same time, it has shortened of fertile land, diminishing this land, and shortened of water. And unfortunately, the problems for agricultural challenges is not really discussed in science and logic. In my presentation here, I choose a specific thing, which is right now is taking an international debate in Codex food labeling and everywhere. Should we regulate labeling for genetically modified genetic products, foods mainly, as mandatory or voluntary? Countries with mandatory labeling, like Australia, European Union, Japan, New Zealand, Norway, Russia, Saudi Arabia in the area, South Korea, Switzerland, Taiwan, and China, they think that consumers need this information to make informed choice. The freedom of a choice, this is one of the basic human rights. Fine, but we need to know how much this is going to cost us. Opposing countries like US, Canada, or Hong Kong, and South Africa think that mandatory labeling for GM are appropriate when there is undisputed scientific evidence that food component is harmful, which is not the case for the GMOs. Some studies have been published on the cost of mandatory labeling in developed countries. Those studies in the developed countries were based on consumer survey to measure the willing to pay for labeling, or the cost generated during processing GMO, or the label for the print itself, the cost of the print of the label itself. But only a few of them estimated the overall cost of labeling. Only two studies were carried out in developing countries, one from Filipino and one from India. Other costs for verification, testing facility, upgrading laboratories, segregation through transportation and the storage, etc., must be taken in account when mandatory GMOs labeling is considered in developing countries, which need a lot of upgrading for those components. Reasons for labeling. Labeling is a method of communication between three parties, between the producer, the seller, and the consumer. Label facilitate fairness in the market, can provide consumer with information that they need to make a proper food choice as a seller. Food label may tell consumer about quality of the product, appropriate use of the product, benefit of the product, possible risk from the product, whether a product is produced, where it's produced, the country of origin, the name, and the manufacturer, other things like that. How the product is produced. Government has a potential role in bolstering mandatory, voluntarily labeling and decide what information must be labeled. That is the role of the country. Whether a food label is mandatory or not, there are guidelines that must be followed. It's often proposed with the aim of achieving a social goal from labeling, voluntarily labeling, support domestic agriculture food manufacturing, improve human health, and keep the safety of the human health in the proper way, mitigate environmental hazards, avert international trade disputes. Distribution of benefits and costs of labeling could play an important role in influencing the government decision to intervene in labeling. Any intervention needs some consequences, such as changes in consumption choices or product reformulation resulting from labeling will lead to growth in some sectors and decline in others, change in food prices may be undesirable from a political or equity standpoint. Balancing the costs and benefits is the main task for government intervention in Lebanon. And this must be focused on the risk of the product, priority, cost and benefits, consumer and producer concern, and finally, politically exhibitancy. The cost of living, there's two parties going to pay for it, the producer and the government. The producer will pay for capacity of industry to comply with the requirements. The print itself, while the government will pay for verification, testing laboratories, for a specific threshold level, some costs for segregation, for transportation, for storage, and also for enforcement. At the end, the consumer will pay all. When just considered the printing costs, there is some for, now we're talking about the label print. There is some direct cost and indirect cost. That is the label design, the label production, the proofing, the package redesign, the labor is taken, and others. While the indirects will involve in write-off cost and stock on hand, labeling life cycle, marketing cost, legal cost, additional design cost, etc. Some learning lessons from labeling for nutrition, which was a good thing. The total cost for nutrition labeling in the United States cost between 1.4 to 2.3 billion for food industry. The government cost was 160 million for the government. The cost benefit study made by FDA estimated that if consumers change their consumption practices due to food labeling, it will reduce risk of cancer and coronary heart disease alone, and will bring benefits which is double what has been paid for the labeling. But this is if the labeling is beneficial. Existing evidence from Ivory in a study of Ivory in 2007 from developed countries shows that mandatory labeling regulation have resulted in no additional consumer choice or information. Among a few developing countries whose labeling policies must have not effectively implemented their regulations, then it is not more than just something written, but it was not really proven. Genetically modified food and feed products have to be labeled in case of tolerance in threshold of 0.9 as in the EU authorized GMOs parties. Economic effect of labeling are intrinsically linked to the presence or absence of the domestically produced GM crops and import or export GM food products. The three original producers, which they don't voluntarily label food, label GM food, which are United States, Canada, and Argentina, have adopted voluntary labeling approaches. When the first country to adopt a mandatory labeling requirement are large importers that do not produce GM crops, like China, or produce GM crops in very limited area. China and Brazil are only major countries in an intermediate position as a large producer and exporter of GM crops with mandatory labeling. However, China officially only produce GM cotton, which is most of the time they don't need to be labeled. Brazil only produce GM soybean, which tend to be used for animal feed, which again is not labeled. This situation raises a question of whether labeling can be considered as non-tariff barrier or not. This table will give us some information about countries, if they are voluntarily labeled or not, if they are and what commodity they label for. For now, talk more about the cost of labeling for testing. There's two major measures in laboratory to test Fujita, ELISA or BCO. For the ELISA, it is not quantitatively cannot tell us how much GMO there. It just tells you if there is GMO or not. Then it is not really effective. If you are using the strip test ELISA, if you are using the blood test ELISA, then it takes more time, it takes 2 to 4 hours, and also more laboratory it costs for doing the test. The more accurate test is a PCR test, which is sensitive than the ELISA. It's only method that can effectively detect GMO for a particular level. The disadvantage, it takes more time, 2 to 3 days. The cost is between $75 to $300 per sample. It also requires more sophisticated equipment and greater expertise. In Egypt here, in the last 10 months during this year, we sampled 87,000 samples from imported food. If we're going to test for those food, then we need to pay 39 million Egyptian pounds if we are using the PCR on the conservative estimate for $75 per test. The estimate based on very conservative cost of grain testing. Another international agency for auditing in Canada calculated the cost for implementing mandatory labeling in Canada by $35 to $48 per person per year. There is another study by the same agency in New Zealand, and they calculated by about $9 to $2.765 per person per year in Australia and New Zealand. Study reports that the total setup cost for mandatory labeling in Canada costs $161 million, which is equivalent to $20 per person per year. The variable cost for mandatory labeling after this implementation could go up to $28 million annually, equivalent to 3.5 per person per year for a Quebec state in Canada. These total estimates are relatively low, perhaps reflecting the very low use of target GM crops by regional farmers and the lack of explicit threshold driven in the analysis. In the United Kingdom, they have 5 scenarios for calculating the cost for labeling. It depends on how much you want to apply the mandatory labeling, and they range from 0.23 cents to 3.89 cents. If you want to do it on the meat fed with GM, processing grades, and products derived from GM in general. Estimated cost for labeling GMO per person per year in Egypt, if we took the lowest estimated number from the developed country, which is $3.8 for 80 million person, and we are in Egypt 91, and I consider that we have 10 million outside Egypt, then we have 80 million people, then the total cost was $381 million, which is dollars, which is close to 1.8 billion Egyptian pounds. This makes us think twice before now, if you talk about priority, and what is the priority for if you want to abandon risk of food, of any contamination of food. And we have this amount of money, I think we will hesitate 100 times before we start labeling for GM. We have a lot more things, more seriously, needs to be banned, like the use of pesticides on the market, having a system for monitoring primary production for agriculture, whether for animal or for plant. Definitely there is other certain sources of food contamination which you need this money than just to satisfy one thing, which is the right for the consumer to know what he needs. Again, in the study in India showed that the increase of food will go up to 11 to 12% if we voluntarily regulate, and that increase definitely is like 10% all over the food chain. It concludes that given the high cost of implementation and uncertainty of the international regulatory context, would be better to avoid immediate use of mandatory labeling. Instead, they suggested a progressive policy alternative initiated with the introduction of voluntary labeling system while waiting for possible international standard on labeling. Another study aims to quantify cost of traceability on coexistence system for GM food from seed to food level for sugar, wheat, starch, and rapeseed oil for human consumption in Germany, and found that under the 0.9% threshold for labeling of GM food. Altogether, the measures ensure coexistence and traceability led to 5 to 13% higher in price for GM free rapeseed oil, 2% to 5% higher price for GM free sugar, and 8% price increase for GM of free wheat starch. In New Zealand also, therefore, some studies for the consumer, to survey the consumer if he wants to label or not. For the New Zealand, they said that they accept labeling. Another study in US said that the US citizen really does not care much about it and it does not see justification for labeling. Third study in between US and Europe, and they found that US consumer again suffer if they do labeling, while the European consumer might benefit from labeling. Then it differs from place to place, from country to country. In Egypt here, I did some study in 2 years ago in 9 different governments. And in each government, I sampled people from high rank brevets to very poor province. It's like 5 locations in every government. And the study revealed that 50%
Thank you. 50%
of the total households people, they spend 75% of their income on food. Then if 75% of the income goes to food, then 10% higher is really cause problem for the consumer. Then, at the end, I would like to say that food labeling is costly and increase food price. It is wrong when GM food shows no difference with the other food and implies that GM foods are unsafe. There is no much space on food products for GM labels, and it segregates the market. Thank you.